Pablo comes down the front speedway right now with a white flag with a 14.95. 14.95 for Brad Lowe on the first lap. He drags the wall down the back straightaway as he goes into turns three, sets the car well in through turns three, out on turn four, front straightaway he comes, checkered flag in the windshield, cross the line with a time of 14.58. 14.58 for Brad Lowe, first effort. Driver sponsored by Transmission World, Lowe's Auto Parts, East Tennessee Metal, AutoZone, Rick's Handyman Service. Also sponsored by Bob's Golf Carts, as slow as he's going. Here he comes out of the fourth turn. He'll step on it, come down the front straightaway. Starts his first qualifying effort, heading into turns one and two. Runs a smooth line out of turn two, down the back straightaway he goes. Let's see how he sets the car in turn three, cuts the low side, drifts up the racetrack, scrubs off a little speed as he comes out of turn four. White flag comes out, time of 15.49, 15.49 for the number 29 of Rusty Ballinger. And Rusty works the low side of turn three this time, comes up the front straightaway, should be a little bit quicker as he crossed the line, a 15.26. 15.26 for the number 26 of Rusty Ballinger. Out on the racetrack right now is the number 25 machine. This driver is sponsored by MR Automotive, Dan's Bobcats, DJ's Performance Race Engines, and Gardner Towing. In the number 25, ladies and gentlemen, Scott Gardner works his way out of the third turn. Scott stands on it, come up the front straightaway, white flag in the air, time of 15.19 for Scott Gardner. Second lap around the racetrack, comes up to the line and touches the checkered flag with a time of 15.17. 1.517 for the number 25 of Scott Gardner, the 01 race car. The driver sitting behind the wheel of this machine is Brian Gardner. He's sponsored by G&G Trucking, Ford's Automotive Machine Shop, Copeland Creek, Cabin Rentals, and Tri-C Farms, and the Garner Auto Repair. Brian Garner comes up the front straightaway in the Ford's Automotive entry. He takes the white flag with a time of 16.23. 16.23 for the 01 machine. And he works his way out of the fourth turn, takes the high side, a little bit slower this time around. We'll see how he does in his qualifying. Checkered flag comes up, 16.03. A lot slower than his first lap, 16.03 for us. And on the racetrack right now, the number 28 race car, sitting behind the wheel of the 28, this is Johnny Lane. And Johnny comes out of the third turn, working the fourth turn right now. He steps on the front straightaway, flat-footed down the front straight, and he gets a time of 18.14 for Johnny Lane. And he drives straight through the turn, doesn't set the car until late out of the fourth turn. Checkered flag on the speedway. 15.60 for Johnny Lane. And well, ladies and gentlemen, taking the place of Eric Tipton tonight in the T21 is Jason Cardwell. Jason Cardwell. He's sponsored by Frank's Plaster Service, Professional Flooring, Gabby's Alternate, Dwayne's Tree Service. And a 1575, 1575 for the T21 machine. And Cardwell works his way out of the fourth turn on the front straightaway. Let's see what he does this second time around. A 15-2-1, 15-21 for the T21 of Jason Cardwell. Competitor out there on the speedway. Sponsored by Spectacular Salon, KC Race Engines, 2J's Pizza, the B&G Electric entry, the West Haven Speed Equipment number 63. Works his way down inside turns one and two. This is Josh Collins. And Collins throws up a dust storm on the booze it and lose it sign as he gets down the back straightaway. He dives into turn three, flat foots it out of turn four, runs up the front straightaway. Here he is with a time of 1.521, 15.21 for the number 63 of Josh Collins. And Josh comes again on the high side of turn four, because skirts that wall. 14.92 for the number 63 of Josh Collins out of the Speedway. This is Mike Llewellyn. Llewellyn comes down the front straightaway. He'll take the white flag lap as he comes out. The Matlock Maps comes out with a 16.49. 16.49 for the number 22 machine. Oh, and he still gets it under control. How about a 16.88? He was sawing the wheel hard coming out of the fourth turn. Did you see him? You can see the white of his eyes out there. All right, ladies and gentlemen, the Alternate Care Advanced Transmission RT Clap Auto Extend Waste Heaven Speed and Equipment Entry, the Zero Race Car, Ross White on the Speedway. And Ross White works his way into the third turn, bouncing around out of the fourth turn on the front straightaway. White flag's going to be in the air right now. He'll cross the line with a time of 1:05:40, 15:40 for Ross White. Second lap working inside the third turn, bouncing around again as he comes up on the front straightaway. Checkered flag will come out. Time of 15:18 for Ross White. Next competitor on the speedway right now, the number 74 race car, sponsored by Hilliard Construction. In the 74 tonight, that's Clyde Stanton. And Clyde flat foots his Chevrolet. Here he goes, starting his qualifying effort. The green flag's up. He's running. Looks good so far down the back straightaway. Let's see how he sets the car in turn three. Drives straight through the rough spot. And here he is on the front straightaway. Should be a good time, folks. Let's see what he gets. 14.97. First time around for Stanton. And second lap around with a 15.19 for the 74 of Clyde Stanton. Our next competitor roll out on the speedway right now is the number 41 race car. Sitting behind the wheel of the 41, this is Ed Lane.
What is it?
Do you copy that, Stanton?
And the white flag comes out for Ed Lane, first time around. 1888. And Ed works his second lap right now. So the 41 gets across the line. 17:39 for Ed Lane's second lap. And what? Oh my goodness. So Ed Lane about takes out the Pierce machine. So on the speed right now, the McCarter Lumber Company. I'll get myself together here in a minute, folks. The McCarter Lumber Company entry. The number 71 sitting behind the wheel of that race car. That's Pierce McCarter. Pierce McCarter driving the 71. And here he is out of the fourth turn. He's got his first lap in the books right here as he gets the green flag going. And Pierce learning his way, getting a little seat time, folks, trying to get a handle on the late model. That's what we like to see, the younger drivers moving up through the field. 16.61 his first lap, starting off in that Pure Mini division, coming up in the classic race cars, did a good job there, got a main event win. Now he's moved in the late model division, so giving this young driver all the credit in the world, trying to step up to drive a late model. And a 16.33, so good effort from Pierce McCarter. So getting a little seat time means all the difference in the world for the late models. All right, ladies and gentlemen, on the racetrack right now, the number one race car, you know him. This is Charles Hurst. He gets one lap. He's working it right now. He'll take the checkered flag. We'll see what he does on a first qualifying and only qualifying lap he gets. 1-5-3-6, 15-36 for the 1H machine, the Hurst Racing entry, as he'll go to the pit area. Frog Engel also on the speedway. The Boyd's Creek Superstar right there, the number 93 machine. One lap for him as well. His GTO is on the speedway. Green flag's up. He's out. He's ready to go running. Let's see what he does. Oh! It looked good for a moment.
That's his lap.
Well, we'll give him a perfect 10 for a nice perfect spin there on turn two. How's that sound? Well, maybe an 8 because he didn't keep it going. He kind of stopped there, so. He's entitled to finish that lap, but the qualifying effort's not going to be a count, so.
Yeah. 35.77.
Well, let's just say that it was more than a half a minute. Red Mod Mini there at the back of the field. Here we go, folks. Going to go racing probably in a lap or two. What do you think, Mark? You ready? Mark Bells is ready. He's got the green flag in hand. We're going to go racing, folks. Here we are, 411 Motor Speedway, Saturday Night Racing, getting underway right here. Green flag's out, and we are racing. So Jamie James takes the white flag. He's got the race lead right now. One lap to go as he heads down inside turn one and two. Tommy Mettler doing a fine job in the 44 machine. Jamie out of the fourth turn. He'll see the checkered flag. Takes the win. Tommy Mettler runs in that second spot. Coming across the line, William Arrowwood. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for the J5, Jamie James. He'll come across here on the front straight away. He takes our first heat race win of the night. And that's always nice to get the first win in, seeing the checkered flag. Well, ladies and gentlemen, you got a quick moment to head to the concession stand. Jackie down there has got something special for you, the Jackie Special. Get in line right now to take advantage of what she's got to offer you. Good-looking lady down there selling out hot food. Go see her right now in the concession stand. Here we come down the front straightaway, second heat race. Mod Mini's getting ready to go. Racing green flags out. They're underway. Brian Gregory, race leader, three laps in. White flag out. Here comes Ernie Collette. He'll try to make some move on side of Brian Gregory. Down the back straight away they go. Brian Gregory gets a bumper full of the number 13 off the front straight away. Here they come. He's going to try to do a drag race to the line. Brian Gregory. Ernie Collette. And then Corey Caton, 93. So Brian Gregory, just by a bumper, gets around the number 13 machine of Collette, and he'll take the win. So Bobby Cowan with the win, Luke Fox in second. The 3T dropped out of that race. Crate Modified's down a little bit on their entry tonight. So Mr. I Have No Idea in the 88 is going to pull and stop right there. He'll run that second heat race in the street stocks, folks. Good field of street stocks in the first heat race. You can tell right now who's going to be the winner of this one. Anybody got a number? Who's going to win it? All right, well, we'll see. 4-4 is up in the air. I saw that number come up. Here we go. The 10's on the Speedway. Good start, even across the line. Bradley Llewellyn jumps to the high side. 77 going down the inside. Here we go. Race is underway. Oh, and Gregory thumps the back of the 77. And yellow flag comes out. Gives a little love tap to the back of the Welling saying, hey, buddy, come on, don't drag me out here. Don't be playing cat and mouse with it. We'll work our way into the third turn. Out of the fourth turn they come. Side by side. It's McCarter going a little bit higher. They'll drag race down the front straightaway. Got a good start. Reno misses a gear. And Reno gets passed by Ogle as they are. Williams coming down the back straightaway. Reagan Williams right behind Bradley Llewellyn as they go into the third turn. pressure on Bradley Llewellyn as they work their way out of the third turn. He'll dive to the inside for the front straight of a drag race. As the yellow flag comes out. The number 10 race car, a little racy out there, ladies and gentlemen. Dave Smith driving that number 10 on the Speedway. Haven't seen this driver out here before, but doing the Reagan Williams race car. Travis Reno on the original start missed a gear, dropped way back, and was able to gather himself back up and move back into the third spot. But you watch Reno push that Williams machine around. Let's see who's going to get it back here on the restart. Dave Smith back there in the fourth spot. He is a contender. Let's see if he can get some running room here. Here they come. Green flags out and we're racing. Llewellyn gets the good job, pulls away. Reno on the inside. And Reno, Reagan battling it out, bumping it out, white flag on the racetrack. Travis Reno looking down low, but it's going to be Bradley Llewellyn. Takes the checkered flag, the win, Reagan Williams, Travis Reno, Dave Smith, Eric White, McCarter, Miller, the last handful of cars on the Speedway. Well, ladies and gentlemen, a good race right there. Bradley Llewellyn takes the checkered flag in the wind. Reagan Williams comes across the line in second. Then it was Travis Reno, who was giving a bumper full to the 48 machine, comes across the line in third. As the front runner, come on, Big Bird, come on, Casper, catch up. All right, we're gonna go racing. Gary McCarter pulling the field, side by side, nose to tail. Here's the green. Oh, and we see a jump start by the number 39. Everybody point your finger at BJ and say, no, 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 BJ. You can't do that. Here we go. Shermanator, McCarter. McDaniel takes off to the early lead. Here comes BJ. And so Big Bird lost its beak, and now he's hit the big tire. All right, folks, one more time. Gary McCarter, the Shermanator, front runners right now, bringing them down the front straightaway. Green flags out and we're racing. to the number 70. The Shermanator jacks off the right side or left side of the car, so it's snapped off. He'll go to the pit area. He's done. Then na 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 na. Okay, nice and slow like coming out of the third turn. Here we go. Let's get excited. Green flags out, we're racing. White flags out. Jason Ogle making a move on Brian McDaniel. The race inside turns 3 and 4. McDaniel on the high side. Drag race down the front straightaway. It's going to be Ogle, McDaniel, Brad Mills, and Casper, the number 88 machine, comes across the line in fourth. Moment right now coming across the line, the 49. Put your palms together for Jason Ogle, takes the heat race win. Andrew Kennedy, and in the 32 is Marcus Baxter. First heat race classic race cars getting ready to get underway as they make their way down the back chute. We'll see if the classic race cars know how to do a start. Side by side, here they come. Nose to tail, up the front straightaway, Marvin Ray hits the throttle. And we're green. Ladies and gentlemen, right there at the line, the number 98. Got it just by the black of that bumper over the number 6 of Logan Duke, so he'll get credited with the heat race win. Second place going out to Logan Duke, obviously. Third place is the number 57. Bobby Bohannon driving the number 60. And here they come out of the fourth turn, side by side, nose to tail, Robbie Sands, J.U. Banks. Green flags out and they're racing. the 57 and the 7 touch as they go into turn 2. The 57X of Adam Hicks and Bart Baxter run into each other as he's smoking the tires. Yellow flag comes out as we see Robbie Sands and Jay Eubanks trying to get out of the way. Oh my goodness, dodging the bullet right there. Two cars tangled up, but the yellow flag comes out. Comes back out, we're back underway. White flag. The checkered flag comes out. Robbie Sands, Jay Eubanks battling at the line. It's Robbie Sands, Jay Eubanks, Bobby Bohannon, and the number 57X of Adam Hicks. The four cars getting across the line. So good race there from Robbie Sands and Jay Eubanks as they get into the pit area. Second heat race done. Now it's the Tennessee R. Ladies and gentlemen, here they come down the front straight with the green flags out, and they're racing. Freddie Hilliard, number two machine, gets tangled up. Excuse me, Steve Hilliard, the number two machine, gets tangled up. No yellow on the speedway. Robbie Comer still the race leader. Robert Martin, Slick Nick in the third spot. White flag comes out. Robert Martin second, Chase King third, Slick Nick and Cindy and Freddie right there in that order. All right, folks, what do we got going on? Oh yeah, it's a heat race for the late models. Got to keep up here. It's hard for me to do that sometimes. Clyde Stanton, Ross White, and the top spot. Here they come. Green flags out of racing. Santa works his way out of the fourth turn. He'll see the white flag this time around. Ross White running second. The 28.
Johnny Lane. Ballinger.
Pierce McCarter. It's going to be Clyde Stanton and Ross White. Then the 28 of Johnny Lane. So Clyde Stanton wins that first heat race for the late models. Kim Morgan, where are you at? I know you're in the stand someplace. Show me where you're at. Somebody show me where Kim is at. She's over there somewhere. Got her own sponsorship, 40 years old. Here we go, racing. Green flag should come out. Takes the checkered flag, the win. Scott takes second. Brian third. Michael Welling dodges the wall for fourth. Cardwell stepping in for Eric Tempton in the T21 machine. He gets the second heat race win. So good job from Jason Cardwell. Driving the number 17 white machine in the back of the field right there, the number 3 race car, that's Jeff Beam. No respect for those lady drivers, is it? Spot right now. They'll see the white flag coming around this time. Adam Engel on the low side. Green on the outside. Here they come. Down the front straightaway. White flag in the air.
Yes.
Second place. Third going out to the number 11 of Josh Dyer. So Andrew Green and Adam Engel battling with the top spot, making his parents proud right there. How about, oh my goodness. Jeff Bean's trying to. Jackie Gibson. All right, folks, if you want to get in on the 50-50 drawing, just stay where you're at. They'll walk down the front. You'll see Cassie Corum down there running around with a little pink top. Leslie down there also. They'll come to you. Just raise your hand up if you want to get into the 50-50. Hands up. Green flag. We're racing. Callie, you got to sing the national anthem. And you got to do it in about 1 minute. So the white flag on the speedway right now for the drivers of Mark Ettinger, Eric Bean, Michael Lambert, or excuse me, James Lambert, then Michael Lambert. Checkered flag comes out.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank y'all for coming tonight. We really appreciate you being here on July the 11th. The first person we want to recognize tonight is our fast qualifier, the Chuck Ward Real Estate Investments Fast Time. He'll get a $100 check. Let's hear it with a 14:54 fast time tonight for Seymour's own Brad Lowe. How's the car feel tonight, Brad?
Feel pretty good. We had to do quite a bit of work on it. Last week we stripped the spool out in the rear end, and I want to thank Biggin up there. He put the rear end back in it this week, and we went and tried it out last night. We run second, got beat by just a couple cars, and we just, I believe it'll be all right.
Good deal. You think it's your turn finally to get you one? It's been a little while.
Yeah. I don't know. We'll see. I hope.
Good deal. I'll tell you, there's a couple of fast cars out there, the 74 and the 63 and that T21. I'll tell you, Jason Clark will drive anything, won't he?
Yep.
He was in Brad's car last week and run second. I really appreciate Brad. This shows a class act right there when you let somebody else borrow your car to stay in the points. And hats off to Eric Tipton there tonight, too. I'll tell you, Jason looks good tonight. I think we're going to see a whale of a show from late models. Let's give Brad Lowe another big hand for that 14:54 for fast time tonight. We'll sing our national anthem.
Hey, Chris.
Yeah, ma'am.
Down there on the speedway right there, Joe Bird. Hey, Joe, raise your hand. It's your birthday, Joe. Everybody say happy birthday, Joe.
Happy birthday, Joe.
Happy birthday, Joe. Hey, and Joe's son won a four-wheeler race out here last night. He put it on my daughter, Callie, so he ran a good four-wheeler race. And Joe, how old are you?
56 years old, he said. 56?
I think he said 26, maybe 36. Anyway, I don't know what we'd do without Joe either. He's a good tech man. Okay, if I could ask everybody just to remain standing, we'll do the national anthem.
broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. O'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Thank you, Callie. Callie's my 11-year-old daughter. She always fills in for me. We'll always have a break or two when we don't have a person to sing a national anthem, and Callie does a pretty good job there filling in.
So Steve Parrott in the number 26 machine gets around and gets a little help with the push from the 20 of Robert Hartwell, bringing out the up single file, going back to a restart. They'll line up this way. The number 36 should. green flag comes back out. We're underway. Ernie Collette digs in down low on the 36 machine. Brian Gregory to the outside. He tries to pitch him down. Collette doesn't give any room. Here they come up the front straightaway. And Gregory does not let him get by, but Collette doesn't relinquish that spot. He hits him. And they both spin. Oh, my goodness. They both touch, both spin. Yellow flag comes out.
And we're starting over.
All right, here we go. Brian Gregory, Jamie James, Corey Kate, William Arrowwood, Hartwell. Top five cars coming out of the fourth turn. Here they come down the front straightaway. We'll see a green flag this time around. He goes to the back. Yellow out. So Brian Gregory again snakes him down. He's at the back. Here we go. Green flag comes out. We're racing. Leaves a few of his parts behind. The number 10, William Arrowwood. So Brian Gregory leads the field with Jamie James. Ernie Collette coming from the back of the field into third spot now. 14 laps complete out of the 20-lap main event. Here we go. Back to green. Flags out. We're racing. Green flag's out, we're racing. White flag on the Speedway. Ernie Collette trying to make a race out of it, but it's going to be Brian Gregory. Takes the win. Checkered flag. Ernie Collette, Corey Kate, Jamie James in that order. The man of the moment is going to make his way down the front straightaway right here. The Toyota Boys Racing entry, the 10-mile service, 24-hour towing, number 36. Give it up for Brian Gregory. All right. Crate Modified's coming out of the Speedway right now. Sounds like about my measurements. Give it up for Brian Gregory, the O'Reilly Auto Parts number 36 machine. 26-31-76 is a winner. Bobby Cowan trying to put the move on Luke Fox. He's finally caught up to him. They're running side by side down the front. And Bobby finally gets out in front. And he spins out. They're lined up one more time. Here we go. We'll see the green flag coming out. Bobby Cowan coming back. White flag on the racetrack. Three drivers battling with the top spot. Who's going to get it? Here they come. Bobby Cowan almost takes him out, and he spins to a stop. He had it. Luke Fox led him in battling for the top spot. There we go, folks. Good finish right there. Matt Letterman takes the checkered flag. He gets the win. After the yellow flag came out, they bunched back up. Luke Fox was out there in the lead. Letterman and Bobby Cowan. It looked like Cowan was going to get it done as he got to the inside. He couldn't hold on to it. Spun it to a stop inside turn two and comes across the line in the third spot. Man of the moment right there, the 3T machine, Matt Letterman. Hey, ladies and gentlemen, get your... So a whole handful of prizes. Here's the number. 26. 30. 76, 26, 30, 76, you are a winner of the grand prize. All right, folks, are you ready to go racing? Stand on your feet, street starts. Green flags out and we're racing. So the number 39, B.J. Williams, swats. Number 39 machine, got a flat tire, can't get it fixed because the pit crew forgot to bring a tire. It's a tough break for the 39. He'll step out of the machine, and that means Bradley Llewellyn, Reagan Williams, Travis Reno, Jason Ogle, Brian McDaniel, Brad Mills, Dave Smith, all in that order coming down the front straightaway. Green flag's going to come out. We're racing. So Bradley Llewellyn snakes the field with him behind. The 49, Jason Ogle, Brian McDaniel, Brad Mills, Dave Smith there in the fifth spot. Here we go, green flags out and we're racing. Brad Mills. So, folks, we're going to go back to start again. Here we go, Bradley Llewellyn. Jason Ogle, Brian McDaniel, Dave Smith now in the fourth spot. The ghost driver, Casper, in the 88. Here we go. Up the front straightaway. It should be a green flag this time around. Nope. Somebody's cheating. Somebody's trying to cheat out there. Who is it? I'm back up. Single file. Cannot pass. Cannot start until you get to that. Thanks. yellow caution flag comes out. Eric White, the 82 machine, spins inside on the bottom. Does come out. Here they come, Bradley Llewellyn, Jason Ogle, Reagan Williams. Green flags out, we're racing. So bye-bye, 50. So Bradley Llewellyn brings the field. Reagan Williams, the 88 Ghost Driver, 52 of McCarter. So Justin bringing him down. The Ghost Driver, Casper, Justin McCarter, Eric White, Brad Mills. The number 10 driver, Dave Smith. Green, white, checkered coming up. Green, white, checkered coming up, folks, for you in the stands. Here we go. Bradley Llewellyn, Reagan Williams, Justin McCarter, Eric White, Dave Smith. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that's going to be one of the officials to make the call on that race right there. But let me tell you, you saw what happened here on the front straightaway. Bradley Llewellyn and the 48 Reagan Williams battling for a position coming down the front straightaway. They got tangled up on the side. They touch each other coming out of turn four. Llewellyn got sideways. Then Reagan took them all the way around. Llewellyn parked on the front straightaway. Thank you. doing their best to sort this one out, folks. Obviously, it's not good. We're going to figure out who's going to call this one. Is penalized for rough driving, so he's out. The 10 car, Dave Smith, gets the checkered flag and the win. And here comes Dave Smith around the front straightaway. And there's your winner, Dave Smith. Give it up for Dave. Flags out! We're racing Classic Division. Yellow flag coming out for Marcus Baxter, the classic race car, takes it into turn two, spins it around, bringing out the yellow flag. So lining them back up one more time, folks. Single file down the back straightaway. Logan Dukes, Drew Kennedy, Jay Eubanks, Marvin Ray, Hot Rod Joe Keck, they're that order coming down around the front straight of the green flag should come out. Here we go, green flag's out and we're racing. Marcus Baxter, 32, bringing out the yellow flag one more time. Two times on him. I'll turn the light on so I can see the number. And here we go. Green flag's out. We're racing. So down the back straight away they go. Drew Kennedy working the third and fourth turn. J.U. Banks in tow right now. White flag on display. One lap left to go for the leader. Caution flag. The back markers didn't see who. Here they come. Checkered flag comes out. Winner out there, Drew Kennedy. J.U. Banks in second, Marvin Ray, Hot Rod Joe Keck, and Bobby Bohannon. Top five cars across the line. '26, '29, '91. That's got to be one of my early birds. Who is it? '26, '29, '91. Hat, T-shirt. Somebody raise their hand like they want it. One more time. 26-29-91. That's my race ticket winner. On the racetrack right now, ladies and gentlemen, this is how it's going to go down. The Tennessee RV Super Truck Series on the Speedway. we're going to go back to racing. Robbie Comer, Chase King, Robert Martin. Green flags out, we're racing. You got a tire going one way, the spring going the other. Like something snapped underneath that race car and then it just smacked the wall hard. Well, ladies and gentlemen, Robbie Comer, Chase King, Freddie Hilliard in that order coming down the front straightaway. Green flag should come out. Three laps left to go as the green flag goes in the air. Checkered flag comes out. Robbie Comer, Chase King, Freddie Hilliard, and Robert Martin.
They need to cut them off before it's off.
All right, the lucky ticket number is 07-7-5-6-2. Who's got it? We got a winner? Come on down. Come on down, 077562. If you can get down here where Brian Gregory is, winner of the Mod Mini feature, he will give you what you said. Be careful. Brian Gregory will give you your wins. How much is it, $160? Pretty nice. Okay, Dan, I'll turn it back over to you if you want to announce this nice field of late models we got.
Good job, buddy. Thank you.
For the drivers on the racetrack. Come on, diehard race fans. You know you want to do it. Put them up in the air. One to go. Late models on the racetrack. There we are. That's it. Late model drivers. That's what they're out there for. Your fan appreciation. Low, Josh Collins, here they come, side by side, green flag, South Will Racing. Dodging the bullet, he almost. Clyde Stanton in the 74, Ross White, Johnny Lang, Charles Hirsch, Rusty Ballinger, Mike Llewellyn, Larry Sullivan. Here they come down the front straightaway. Green flag's out, and we're racing. All right, ladies and gentlemen, it's still Josh Collins, Brad Lowe, Jason Cardbrook, Clyde Stanton, Ross White, Johnny Lane, Charles Hirsch, Rusty Ballinger, Michael Welling in that order coming down the front straightaway. Green flags out, we're racing. Coming out this time around. A drag race down the front straightaway. Josh Collins gets in front of Brad Lowe. Jason Cardwell, the third spot. Ross White, fourth. Charles Hurst and Rusty Ballinger in that order. Oh, great race, right? Don't miss much. Again, I know you have choices where you could be at on a Saturday night, and you choose to come out here and be a part of our race family. We want to say thank you from all the staff, the management out here. Thank you so much for coming out here. We'll be back again here next Saturday night right here at the Speedway. But you choose to come here, and that's why we love you. Folks, be careful on the way home. Make sure you buckle up. Leave the racing to the drivers here at the racetrack. Make sure your children are buckled up properly as well. Give it up one more time for Josh Collins on the front straightaway, our late model main event winner. Folks, green flag comes out. We're racing. And the checkered flag comes out for Hettinger. Mark takes away from the rest of the field. Nearly laps the entire field. He lapped everybody except for second place. And third. Excuse me. He gets across the line with the win. Same thing, but even better, I promise. We put on a great show. You'll get some of those track t-shirts. We've got 3X, 2X is on sale. Don't forget to go out and tell all your friends and neighbors, your fellow co-workers of what you saw out here on a Saturday night. Bring a friend next Saturday. We'll have a special thing for Bring a Friend Night. Give it up, Mark Hettinger, one more time. Hey, Mark, good job. Please leave all the racing to the race car drivers here at the racetrack. We want to make sure that you get back here nice and safe next Saturday.